Hi guys, welcome to my videos. So today in this video I'm going to walk you through the Microsoft Stream Admin Center in Office 365. So before I proceed further, if you have not already subscribed to my channel, please go ahead and subscribe right now because I regularly upload videos. And if you have any concern, any question, anything that comes in your mind, feel always absolutely free to ask. This is your own channel. Alright guys, so let's proceed. So guys, in front of you I have opened my Office 365 installation. So under admin centers I have this link all admin centers. So when I open, I see one for Stream. So click on it and it opens a new tab. So this is how it looks. So if I want to assign anybody as admin, then I can do it. Users on this list and all global tenant admins are allowed, so that's why even though I have not added myself here, I still have the admin rights. Next, I have spotlight video. You can have 4 videos as spotlight, but I have not added any. I can click on this add link and I can I can search for the videos, or I can paste the URL. Live events. When enabled, only the below users will be allowed to create live events. So I can enable and then I can add users. Live now. Nobody is live now. Upcoming, there's nothing scheduled now. Okay, so basically some of these facilities you have seen on YouTube as well. Company policies. Link your company's video policy. Text. When enabled, users are required to accept the company policy before uploading a video. Okay. Alright. Usage details. I haven't used even a single gigabyte. Wow. And if the threshold of 85% is reached, then admins will be notified. I have a recycle bin here. Because I have not deleted any video, that's why I don't have anything here. Then I have a link for groups. Microsoft Stream groups are connected to my 365 group. Whenever you create a Microsoft Stream group, it automatically creates Microsoft 365 group in Azure Active Directory. To manage Microsoft 365 groups, either visit Microsoft 365 Admin Center or on Azure portal. Okay. Support. Do we have any option to raise cases here? Oh yes, we can raise a ticket to Microsoft. Comments. When comments are received, users are not allowed to comment on videos. All users are currently allowed to. So this is for restriction. If I restrict it, then users are not allowed to comment on videos. I don't want to do that. Content creation. So here I can restrict. If I enable, only below users will be allowed. Okay. Company-wide channel creation, even I can restrict that as well. Viewing permission, that also I can set default. I have the option to enable third party eCDN solution also. I have managed user data and I have managed deleted users as well. Okay. Discover, I have these things that I can discover. I can view my content. I can create a group. I can upload a video. I can create a channel and I can record screen or video as well. So these are the good things. Once you record the screen or video, it's gonna record, and that recording will be uploaded in Microsoft Stream from where you can access it. So thanks for watching this, guys. I hope you like this video. Make sure you like and comment, and if you have any concern, any question, anything that comes in your mind, feel always absolutely free to ask. Thank you guys.